Time flies so fast. Ang bilis ng panahon. Tapos na ang isang buwan ng bagong taon. 1 month is already done with the new year. And yung mga palamuti, all those blinking colors and blinking lights in the malls, they're gone and they're now replaced with things that are shaped like what we commonly know as hearts. Shopping malls are full of many things in red color. Alam nyo kasi February na, no? And for many, love is already in the air. Kaya tapikin mo ang iyong katabi, sabihin mo, good morning, I love you. Good morning, IBCC. So, sa makaraming pagkakataon, for the end time, we are considering the subject of love. Hindi dahil February ngayon at tayo ay gustong sumunod kung ano ang sineselebrate, but because gusto natin na bigyang halaga and to highlight this month that God is the source of love. Ito yung ating theme for this month. God is the source of love. Hindi tayo nakikiuso lang, mga kapatid. Ha? Hindi tayo nakikiuso. Okay? Ang sa amin lang, ang sa akin lang dito is just we have to learn and understand love in a deeper point of view. Gusto natin na mag-progress yung ating pagkakaintindi sa katagang love or sa katagang pag-ibig. We want to progress in our understanding about love. And when it comes to love, or the topic of love, yung ating Apostle John, he is very repetitive. Okay? Very repetitive. Minsan, pag binasa natin yung kanyang mga sulat, we might even ask ourselves, hindi kaya yung kanyang mga magbabasa find him wearisome and annoying? Kasi makulit. Makulit si Apostle John. He always give emphasis to the topic of love. In fact, kung tutusin mga kapatid, before sa chapter 4, he already touched the importance of love 3 times. Tatlong beses na niyang binanggit yung topic about love 3 times before makadating dito sa chapter 4. And then, binigkas na naman niya rito sa chapter 4. But this time mga kapatid, it is longer and harder and has come full circle. Kung babasahin natin yung binasa ulit natin kanina, it is longer and harder about the topic of love and it comes full circle compared to the other sections ng letter niya that touches about the subject of love. So, let us title our message today with this one, God's Great Circle of Love. Ito yung title natin. Yung verses or the passage that we have just read is the very foundation of love. Mark that. We can also call this as the chapter of love. We will also discover here that love is a very important part of life. Okay? Bakit kamo? Because in these short 15 verses, John repeated the word or its equivalent 27 times. So merong emphasis about the word love or the subject of love at ang kulit ni John. So, let's start the ball rolling by asking these questions. Where does love start? Where does love start? Where does it come from? Sino ang kanyang source? Who is its source? So again, let us again read what the Apostle John told his disciples. Verse 7 to 8 says, "Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God." Underline that. "Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God because God is love." Power. Dito pa lang, kung i-unpack natin to, kulang isang oras. But here, John described the Lord or God as love. Actually, this is the third description of John on who God is. Ang una niyang sinabi of who God is God is Spirit in his gospel in John chapter 4 verse 24. And when he started this letter in chapter 1, verse 15, he said that God is light. Now, he gives a description about God that God is love. Of course, hindi natin masasabi na yung tatlong description na to will completely describe God because we know God is indescribable. Amen? But we know that when John said na pag sinabi ni John that God is light, John was referring to the holy nature of God. Ano ba sa Tagalog ang holy, mga taga Bulacan? Banal. Yung kanyang banal na katangian. Ayun. In the scriptures, may symbols. Think of symbols, mga kapatid. God is light is symbols. Symbol. In the scriptures, in the Bible, pag sinabi nating light, it is a symbol of holiness. Simbolo siya ng kabanalan. And darkness is a symbol of sin. Alam niyo, walang other prophet would say it emphatically. Si Prophet Isaiah said in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 2, and I quote, he said, "The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned." So, mga kapatid, if God is light and God is love, therefore, God's love is a holy realm, is a holy love. Get it? I-follow natin si John. He described God and then he said, God is light. And now he's saying, God is love. And we know that when he says, God is light, means about the holiness of God. So, if God is light and God is love, therefore, God's love is a holy love. So, anong ibig sabihin nito if God's love is a holy love? God expresses His holiness in love. Lahat ng expression ng ating Panginoong Diyos is out of love. Mark this, ha? This is counterintuitive in the world today. But for us, followers of the Lord Jesus Christ, lahat ng expression ng Panginoon is out of His love. This means lahat ng kanyang expression, meaning all His actions, is expressed in love. Lahat ng kanyang ginagawa is expressed in His love. Even yung kanyang judgment is expressed in love. Do you believe that? Lahat. Because God is love, so lahat ng kanyang expression, lahat ng ating makikita patungkol sa kanya is about love. So that person that is beside you right now is God's love. Look at them. Even His judgment are expressed in love. Alam nyo, mayroong isang mama, isang a man that is so dear and so close to me. And I love him very much. Hanggang ngayon, he is still asking this age-old question, if God is love, why all these sufferings? Alam nyo, this is a very profound question, mga kapatid. And many ask this question. But I think we can do better than that. I think we can ask better than that. Paano kung i-reconstruct natin yung question the other way around? And paano kung ganito ang tanong natin? Why do we suffer? Instead of, if God is love, why all these sufferings? What if we ask ourselves, why do we suffer? Bakit may pain? Bakit may mga paghihirap? Bakit we experience all these things? Let's go back. If we read the story of the nation of Israel, we will understand why. Kung babasahin natin yung kwento ng mga Israelitas, maas iintindihan natin kung bakit. After all, Israel is an object lesson for all of us. That's why it's very important to read the history. It's very important to read the Old Testament so that you can relate where we are right now. Dahil ang istorya ng nasyon o the nation ng bansang Israel is an object lesson for all of us. And the prophet Jeremiah understood this fully. Alam natin na si prophet Jeremiah was the weeping prophet, di ba? Umiiyak. Sinong iniiyakan niya ang kanyang bansang Israel? Kasi nakita niya ang Israel is already very, very down. Again, on captivity. So while he was looking at the nation of Israel and looking at the situation of the people of Israel while in captivity, meron siyang binanggit doon sa Lamentations chapter 3, verse 22 to 23. Yung sinabi niya, and I quote, "Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for His compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness." Alam natin ang istorya ng Israel, di ba? Who knows the story of the Israelites people? They were the chosen people of God. They were given everything. And yet, they slipped down and slipped down and slipped down, and then they were taken out from captivity. They were so prosperous, and then went down, then they go back to captivity again. This is why si Jeremiah ay umiiyak. And he said, dahil nagreklamo yung mga tao, bakit may suffering? They didn't know that suffering came. They brought it to them. Kaya ang sabi ni Jeremiah, "Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed. For His compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness." So, ang sagot, kasagutan sa question kanina is that love starts with God because God is love. Love starts with God because God is love. John, ni-record ni John yung pag-uusap ng Panginoong Hesus Kristo tsaka ni Nicodemus doon sa rooftop ng bahay ni Nicodemus. Ang sabi ng Panginoong Hesus Kristo kay Nicodemus, "For God so loved the world." God is the source of love. It starts and begins and ends in Him. Alam nyo, yung pag-ibig ng Panginoon, ang pag-ibig ng Diyos is very different to the love that the modern world knows. Kakaiba yung love ng Panginoon na pinapadama niya sa atin. Hindi ito yung katulad ng description ng love sa modern times ngayon. Ang modern society's love, walang holiness in there. Walang semblance of holiness. Kaya minsan, kung pakikinggan natin yung mga awitin, it is very clear in how it is being expressed in our songs today. Pakinggan nyo yung mga awitin about yung mga love songs today. Gaganda ng mga yung melody, ang ganda ng harmony, but listen to the lyrics. That's how the world right now expressed the word love. Alam nyo, it tends more into the carnal and selfish expression of love. Kaya nga, merong mga ibang mga kanta na nakalagay doon sa baba, warning, explicit lyrics. So, God's love is not like that. Kaya ang Apostle John is so passionate about in teaching his readers about the topic of love. Mga kapatid, ito yung realidad. We did not sought God. Hindi natin hinanap ang Panginoon. Hindi natin, di ba? Naniniwala ba kayo doon? We are not seeking God. Romans 3:11, and I quote Paul saying, and I quote, "There is no one who understands. There is no one who seeks God." Walang naghahanap sa Diyos. Kung iniisip natin na that's why we have love right now because we're seeking God, no. There's no one who seeks God. Ang katotohanan, God has been seeking us. Siya yung original na seeker. Yung ating paghahanap sa Panginoong Diyos ay natural na response natin of the love of God. Kasi yung kanyang pag-ibig, His love has been there since the foundation of the world. Since nung ginagawa ang mundo, yung kanyang pag-ibig ay hinahanap na tayo. He was seeking us. Ang sabi ng Apostle Pablo sa Ephesians, Ephesian letter niya, sabi niya, "For He chose us in Him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in His sight, in love." So hindi tayo sabihin na, "I was seeking God." No, your seeking God is an expression, our natural response to the love of God. Okay, kaya sometimes we really have to understand how God works. Kasi we are really bombarded right now of the meaning of love, of what it is in the world. Okay. So, merong pangalawang question. Ang yung pangalawang question should be like this. If God has been seeking us ever since, kung hinahanap tayo ng Panginoon noon-noon pa man, what has He been doing? What did His love do? Ano yung kanyang ginagawa? Ano yung kanyang ginawa? Ito ang katotohanan. True love is never static or inactive. Ang totoong pagmamahal, ang totoong pag-ibig ay hindi stagnant, hindi static, at hindi inactive, hindi gumagawa at hindi gumagalaw. True love is never static or inactive. Merong kanta si John Mayer, siguro yung mga ibang mga young people dito, alam nila, narinig nila tong kanta na to. He put it rightly in one of his songs. Nasabi niya, love is a verb, it ain't a thing, it's not something you own, it's not something you scream. When you show me love, I don't need your words, your love ain't a thing, love is a verb. Mga teachers, ano yung verb? It's a word of action. You see, God communicates and He must communicate. Not only in words, but in deeds. So, nakikipag-usap ang Panginoon sa atin, not only sa mga salita, but also in deeds, sa kanyang action. You see, God reveals His love to us in many ways. Maraming pagkakataon. He has been meeting our needs. Kaya lang, we're expecting something more. The more that we receive, the more that we expect something more. Kaya nga sabi nung aking kasama dati na nag-retire na sa trabaho, sabi niya, blessed are those who doesn't expect for they shall not be disappointed. Tama? No? Pero when we receive something, we expect more. So that's why we forget to thank the giver. God has been meeting our needs. Unang-unang, He started that in the Garden of Eden. It was a perfect home for love to thrive and a perfect home to serve God. Pero alam natin yung story. We all know the story. We all know the story. Man fell into sin, brought the whole world, and brought the creation into bondage. Kaya ngayon, we're living in a very precarious, uncertain world. Pero but even then, mga kapatid, even if man fall into sin, God did not stop loving us. Hindi tumigil yung kanyang pagmamahal. Kaya pagbabasahin natin again yung scriptures, God revealed His love in more ways than one when He chose the sons of Jacob, the nation of Israel. Nagyabang pa nga yung mga taga-Israel dahil sila daw yung chosen God at chosen people of God. Pero may warning sa kanila. Deuteronomy 7 verse 7 to 8 says, the Lord did not set His affection on you and choose you because you were more numerous than other peoples. For you were the fewest of all peoples. Hala! Hindi pala yun yung dahilan. And verse it says, but it was because the Lord loved you and kept the oath He swore to your ancestors, and He brought you out with a mighty hand and redeemed you from the land of slavery, from the power of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. And verse 9 says, know therefore that the Lord your God is God. He is the faithful God, keeping His covenant of love to 1,000 generations of those who love Him and keep His commandments. So kahit na nagkasala na yung tao, even if man was vanished outside from the Garden of Eden, God's love never stopped, patuloy. And in fact, He chose a group of people so that His love will emanate from them and the world will see that God is true. Pero these people failed God. So how does this relates to us? Ano ang relation nito sa ating ngayon in the present times? How does this kind of love affects us? Dito si Apostle John naging mas malalim at naging mas harder yung kanyang mga words in his letter. This is where John presented the greatest expression of God's love. Sabi ng siguro ng Panginoong Diyos, kailangan ko nang mag-intervene. Because in these verses, John presented the greatest expression of God's love. Verse 9 to 10 of what we have just read a while ago. This is how God showed His love among us. He sent His one and only Son into the world that we might live through Him. This is love, not that we love God, but that He loved us and sent His Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Very clear. Alam ng Panginoon that we will not be able to love God the way He wanted it to be. So that's why He sent His Son. Para makita na merong yung kanyang pag-ibig ay may galaw, may action. Hindi sa word lang. That's why He sent the Lord Jesus Christ, His Son, to be an atoning sacrifice. Alam nyo, yung atoning sacrifice na to, yung mga bright minds, yung mga bright scholars, ayun ko kung bakit nila pinapahirapan pa tayo para maintindihan yan. Meron silang word na tinatawag na propitiation. I don't know kung bakit kailangan pang pahirapan, Pastor. Pwede namang sabihing sacrifice. This is full payment of our sins. For those scholars that are listening and, you know, worshiping with us, it's called propitiation. Baka kasi sabihin nila, hindi natin inaral. I can just recall my reading sa book of Exodus and Leviticus. You see, my God, how God ordains yung book ng, the latter part ng book ng Exodus at earlier part or the whole book of Leviticus, it is how God describes to His people yung mga commandments on that pertains to animal sacrifices para mapatawad yung kanilang mga kasalanan. Alam nyo, yung commandments ng Panginoon with regards to the animal sacrifices are intricate. They were so detailed and all of that has to be followed. At kung babasahin natin ng the earlier part o siguro mga middle part ng Book of Leviticus, merong insidente doon mga kapatid that cost the lives of sa dalawang anak ni Aaron. Because nakalimutan nila ang protocol on how to get, saan kukunin yung apoy para sa pansunog doon sa sacrifice. They forget the protocols on how to do the rituals and ceremonies. Right there and then, mga kapatid, they died. Pero yung kanilang mga suot na priestly vestment, buong-buo. It only showed that God is holy and tells us that we cannot mess with the holiness of God. Hindi pwedeng ipagsawang bala, bahala lang natin yung holiness. Alam nyo, in the olden times, in the church kung saan kami dati nang galing sa Davao, Davao City Alliance Gospel Church, when we were still young and our kids are small, yung mga nakakatanda, bawal ang mga bata na tumakbo dito sa altar. That's why we built a Sunday school para nandun sila because for them, they were trained that it is unholy to mess with the holiness of God in time of worship. So ganun, pero ngayon we're so liberal with regards to that. Gusto nyo maging ganun tayo rito? So that's why we want you to understand the holiness of God. We want to understand God's love. In what happened to the sons of Aaron was telling us that God is holy and we cannot mess with the holiness of God. Alam nyo, kahit anong gawing sakripisyo, man would never get into the mold of God's holiness. Kailangan ng intervention ng nagagaling sa Panginoon mismo. Kaya may sinulat si Apostle Pablo sa Romans 5:8 about how this expression of God, of this love of God expression to us was given. Chapter 5, verse 8, "But God demonstrate His own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Hindi pa tayo napapatawad, the Lord Jesus Christ died for us. God demonstrated His love, His own love for that. So, ang ginagawa ng Panginoon is not about just word. Meron talagang action. Because His love is active. Yung word dito na demonstrate, mga kapatid, ang ibig sabihin nito, went public. Kasi yung demonstrate is ang opposite ng secret or hidden. Yan yung ibig sabihin niyan, demonstrate when public, yung makikita ng lahat. Dahil sa unang panahon, in the olden days, in the Old Testament, ang Panginoon ay hidden behind the shadow of rituals and ceremonies. Mababasa natin yan sa Hebrews. Nandun siya sa likod ng holies of holies. But in the life of the Lord Jesus Christ, that life is demonstrated and is made public. So ang answer sa pangalawang question, kung anong ginagawa ng pag-ibig na yan, is that God's love has been active and it still is. Active noon, active kahapon, active ngayon, active sa susunod na mga araw, susunod na mga taon. It's continuing, it's continuous, hindi siya tumitigil. Yung love that's being demonstrated to us by God through the Holy Spirit is being given to us. Kaya si John went on and he says in verse 12 to 14, God lives in us and His love is made complete in us. This is how we know that we live in Him and He in us. He has given us of His Spirit and we have seen and testify that the Father has sent His Son to be the Savior of the world. If anyone acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God lives in them and they in God. And so we know and rely on the love God has for us. God is love. Whoever lives in love lives in God and God in them. Haba, no? Paulit-ulit yung love and love. Pero merong word doon na live. Buhay or buhay or mananahanan. We can summarize this that God is not just content in loving us. Sa mga salita ni John, we can summarize it that God is not only satisfied in loving us or even ipakita na mahal tayo ng Panginoon. He desires to live in us, not just to love us. You see this kind of love? God desires to live in us, not just to love us. To live, para manahan. It is interesting, mga kapatid, no? Kung we're just reading our scriptures, it is really interesting in how God make His presence felt by His people. Doon sa the book of Genesis, ang sabi doon, God walk with men. Naglalakad or kasama araw-araw. God walk with Adam and Eve. Amen? God walked with Enoch. God walked with Noah. God walked with Abraham. In the olden times, ganun yun. That's the description of how God is being revealed to people, to men. He walks with men. But by the time of the Exodus, hindi lang siya naglakad kasama ang kanyang mga tao or His people, He lived and dwelt with them. With them. Kasamang namumuhay. Remember the pillar of cloud by day and the pillar of fire by night? That's the glory of God. Kasama nila. With them. Pero meron pa, people saw the glory of God dwelling in them as God came down and moved into the tabernacle. Nakanganga kayo lahat, parang hindi niyo alam yung aking sinasabi. Kailangan ba nating mag-review? When they were at the wilderness, God commanded Moses to build a tabernacle for him, the Ark of the Covenant. At sabi niya, make a meeting of tent and the Holy of Holies. When you are there, makikita ng mga tao na I am residing there, I am camping with you. You see, God not only dwelt with them, He camped with them. Yung mga mahilig sa camping dito, maiintindihan yun. So, doon sa gitna nila, nandun yung Ark of the Covenant within the tabernacle, that every time that they will sacrifice, makikita nila ang glory ng Panginoon. And when they see the glory of God, all of them bow down and to worship. Pero nakakalungkot kasi if we will really read all these things, pagdating doon sa the book of Samuel, sa 1 Samuel, makikita natin doon mga kapatid that the glory of God departed from them. Umalis ang Panginoon sa kanilang presensya. Hirap, no? When God will depart from you, Hindi lang talo. You're doomed. This is what happened. The prophet Samuel wrote that God's glory departed from his people dahil they kept on sinning. Talagang blatant sinning. If you read yung Kings 1 and Kings 2 and then Samuel 1 and Samuel 2, you can see the history of Israel there. Nandun sila lahat. And it was downhill for the people of God from there. Pababa ng pababa, pababa ng pababa. Downhill. So for many years, ang buhay ng mga Israelites is up and down, is back and forth from victory to defeat. And then finally, they were back into captivity in Babylon for 70 years. So for so many years, hindi nila nakita uli ang glory ng Panginoon. They never saw the glory of God again. Ang tanong sa atin ngayon, did the glory of God came back? Bumalik ba, mga kapatid? You see, this is the basic of the Christian faith. The glory of God came back in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. His glory came back in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because God just don't walk with men. He just don't want to dwell with us. He desires to live in us. Gusto niyang mamuhay sa atin, inside us. That is what His love has been doing, active. Habang ikaw ay tumatakbo, the Lord is running after you. Kahit saan ka pumunta, hindi ka makaka-iskapo sa pag-ibig ng Diyos. Because His love is active. No matter how you try to run away from Him, if your heart has that presence of the Holy Spirit, you will be called and be get back again by the Lord. It's because His love is active and it is in action. So can you imagine what it looks like if God is living in us? Can you picture a world if God is living in each one of us individually? Imagine a world where God lives in each one of us. Alalahanin natin, think of what we have just learned few Sundays ago. Alam nyo kanong sinabi ni Paul in his letter to the Corinthian believers? Your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you and whom you have from God. God's glory departed from His people, totoo. But the Lord Jesus Christ came and promised that the Holy Spirit will abide in us forever. That's the love of God. The Holy Spirit will abide in us forever. John 14:16 says, "And I will ask the Father, and He will give you another advocate to help you and be with you forever, the Spirit of truth." Forever. Hindi tayo iiwanan. Kaya ang sabi ng Panginoong Hesukristo, I will be with you always in the end of days, time. Because He promises already, the Lord's glory departed from His people, but it came back in the presence, in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. So yung title ng mensahe natin sa umagang ito, have said, is God's Great Circle of Love. Ito yung title. If God is the source of love and He has given it to us by loving us, ang pangatlo at last na question is that, where should this love go? Saan to pupunta yung love na to? From God lang ba hanggang papunta lang sa atin? Pero sabi ko nga kanina, in the words of John, it became full circle. Alam nyo tayo mga Pinoy, mahilig tayo sa paligoy-ligoy when we answer questions. Pag tinatanong tayo, ang dami natin sinasabi, no? Paligoy-ligoy, before tayo sumagot. Yun yung kultura natin eh. Kaya most of the time, yung mga sagot natin, mali-mali na. Right? In some culture, or most of cultures around the world, they answer directly. Direct talaga yung answer. And then they make the explanations later. Ano yung tama? Yung tanungin ka tapos magpaikot-ikot muna before yung sagot or sumagot ng diretso tsaka kayo mag-explain? Tingnan nyo yan. Ganyan talaga tayo mga Pinoy. That's how we do it. Pero John never think twice. Hindi niya, he never have to think twice. He was very direct and clear. Ang sabi niya, "Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another." Kung saan papunta tong pag-ibig na to? "No one has never seen God. But if we love one another, God lives in us and His love is made complete in us. Since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God." Yes, because if someone will see God, pulbos, walang matitira. "But if we love one another, God lives in us and His love is made complete in us." John was basically saying that this love must come out from us towards others. Na yung pag-ibig na ating naranasan na nanggaling sa Panginoong Diyos ay dapat will come out from us towards others. To complete the circle. The love that was demonstrated by us, this love must be demonstrated by us by loving one another. Ang sabi ni John, "No one have seen God ever." Walang nakakita. "But if we love one another, people will see God in us and His love towards others." Ginawang public ng Diyos yung kanyang pag-ibig, so we must give it public also. You see, easier said than done, no? Paano yung mga hindi talaga kaibig-ibig? Sama na tingin niyo sa akin eh. Love one another. When you love one another, people will see God in you. Hindi talaga ganun kadali. Even those people that are not lovable, look at the person next to you. Is he or she lovable? Pero the command was, demonstrate it. This love should come from us. You see, the love that we're describing right now, it's different from the love that we understand in the world. Tama? Because the love that is being demonstrated to us is kahit na hindi kaibig-ibig. In fact, hindi tayo kaibig-ibig sa harap ng Panginoon. Kailangan maintindihan natin yan, mga kapatid. Kaya nga, it's easier said than done dahil hindi tayo Diyos eh. Pero alam nyo, doable yan through the grace of God. Do you believe me? Before we end our message, let me give you a testimony. Many years ago, nung maliit pa yung aming baby pa si Ezra, yung aming pinakabunsong lalaki, he was barely a week old. Yung kanyang yaya, who was my niece, pinapadala namin sa school, pinapag-aral namin para makapagtapos siya ng pag-aaral. Nung ipinganak si Ezra, nakita niya na meron ng baby. Oh, nakita niya na parang, mag-aalaga ako ng bata. Tumahimik lang siya. One Sunday, pag-uwi namin galing ng simbahan, hindi na namin siya nadaratnan. Iniwanan kami na ni ho ni ha, wala. So alam nyo mga kapatid, that very time, I was still a new Christian. 1995, pinanganak si Ezra. I was baptized 1993, barely 2 years old in the Christian faith. I was still in the hardest part of my journey. Alam nyo yung reaction ko talaga doon, I was really very, very angry. Lahat, kinuwento ko lahat ng ginawa namin. Kinuwento ko lahat ng ginawa ko. Grabe ka, kinuha kita doon, dinala rito, parang sa sine na binihisa mo, something like that. I was so angry. Mas lalo si Gina nung time na yun, kasi nung time na yun, warrior pa yan, warrior princess. Tatawa siya. Yeah, we were so angry kasi paano kami makakapagtrabaho? Paano dadalhin si Kirk sa school kung lang maiiwan sa baby? And that time, I was still a struggling young engineer na nagtatrabaho. Kailangan namin ng katulong at kinabukasan magtatrabaho. Eh, hindi naman ako pwedeng ura-ura ng mag-file ng leave. Alam ni Ong yan. Hindi pwedeng ura-ura ng mag-file ng leave. So I was really very, very angry. At the deepest part of my heart, I said, you can never come back and ask for help from me again. You will be forever be banned. Banned. 25 years later, fast forward, naka-receive ako ng text message from a number that I don't know. Normally, pagka number lang lumalabas, hindi ko talaga, lalo ngayon na maraming, ano ba yun? Bingo, 50,000, just bingo, ang daming ganyan ngayon. Pero I was intrigued because merong nakasulat doon. Manoy ang tawag niya sa akin, hi Noy. The text is asking how we are after all these years. So sabi ko, who's this? So normal na sagot, medyo may pagkaano pa rin ako, kaya sabi ko, who you? Nagpakilala siya. Noy, this is ganito, ganyan, ganyan. Alam nyo, yung kalit ko 25 years ago, came back. Here you are. Again. So at the back of my mind, nagtitext kasi sigurado akong hihingi na naman ng tulong. After 25 years of not hearing where she is and where. But, you see, I told Gina about it. At the back of my mind, I said, how dare you? Ganun yung normal na reaction natin, right? Pero see, our instant action that time was to pray for forgiveness. And the grace of God flow through us, sa aming dalawa ni Gina, that we were able to give forgiveness to my niece. And the rest, they say, is history. Pwede mga kapatid. It can be done. All you have to do is what Christians should do. Ask God's grace. See, lahat, kung gusto nyo makinig ng detalye ng kwento na yan, mamaya sa life group natin, kaya huwag kayong alis, may life group tayo. Amen? May detalye ako, may detalye si Gina. Yung mga young people, pwede ko kayong sabihan dito para ibigay ko sa inyo yung detalye. Kasi dito, hindi pwedeng dahil sabihan ko lahat, naka-online tayo. Pero you can do that. It's doable. Kaya, if the person beside next to you is unlovable, you can love him or her. Because the command is love one another. Here's one more. His love is made complete in us. This is how love is made complete among us so that we will have confidence on the day of judgment. Tingnan nyo, mga kapatid. In this world, we are like Jesus. In this world, we are like Jesus. What did the Lord Jesus Christ did for us? Look at what is inside and in front of us right now. This is what we're going to celebrate a moment, moments from now. This is God's love. In this world, we are like Jesus. Meron akong another kwento before tayo magtapos. I quote this from the book of John Stott, in his book, The Epistles of John. Ito yung kanyang sinulat doon and I quote. Yung church father na si Jerome said that when the Apostle John was already in his extreme old age, he was so weak that he had to be carried into the church meetings. Kailangan siyang kargahin para makapagsamba. Si Apostle John. At the end of the meeting, he would be helped to his feet to give a word of exhortation to the church. Of course, kasama mo si Apostle John nagwo-worship. Hindi pwedeng hindi mo patayuin yan at pag magsabi ng kahit isang kataga man lang. Amen? Apostle John, kasama ng Panginoong Hesukristo yun. And he was the apostle that the Lord loved. Ano ba yun? Loved by the Parang siya yung pinaka-love ng Panginoon kasi siya yung laging kasakasama. Pagkasama mo sa worship yun, hindi pwedeng niyo pagsalitain yun. Kaya sabi ni Jerome, the father of the church, sabi niya, he is always carried to the church at every time na matapos na yung sambahan, he is carried in front to tell someone or to say something. Ang lagi niyang sinasabi ganito, little children, let us love one another. Every time na siya itatawagin, yun lang ang sasabihin niya, let us love one another. So lahat nung mga nagsisimba, sumasamba ang magkasama, over time they become wary. Over time they become so used to it na yung iba nainis na. And then yung isa hindi ata nakatiis, sinabi niya, bakit kailangan mong sabihin yan ng paulit-ulit? Lagi mo namang sinasabi yan every day or every Sunday or every time na nagkikita-kita tayo. Alam niyo kung ano daw yung reply niya, sabi ni Jerome, because it is the Lord's commandment. And if this only is done, it is enough. Imagine a world that is loving one another. Imagine a world that the people are being lived where God is residing in their hearts. So, i-summarize natin to end the message today. This is the great circle of love. From God to you, to us, to others, so that these others will love God in return. That's the full circle of the great circle of God's love. Nandyan yan sa binasa natin kanina. From God to us, to others, to God again. That's the circle of love. And we must understand what love is all about. Let me end this message with a quote from Warren W. Wiersbe. God is love. It is not simply a profound biblical statement. It is the basis for a believer's relationship with God and with his fellow man. Because God is love, we can love. His love is not a past history, it is a present reality. Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat.